Hey, how's it going, guys? Mr. Boss for the win here, and in today's GTA 5 video, we're going to be talking about some more details surrounding the casino update, including one big problem that Rockstar might have with this DLC, some more details from Rockstar Insiders on when we might see the trailer, which I know a lot of you guys are looking forward to, and a whole lot more. So let's start with that one big problem first. Someone said on the GTA forum site, "I still think there will be a glitch involving some of the games," referring to the casino ones like poker and stuff like that. "For instance, when you lose a game, you can just quickly leave the server, disconnect your internet, or suspend the application. This way you won't lose any money. The same method still works for the orbital cannon and for research purposes for your bunker. They need to change the internal when the server saves your cash. If not, we could be seeing people just leaving the session when they are about to lose. You could possibly exploit this to gain massive amounts of cash without losing some of your own. This will still qualify as a money glitch. I'm not trying to prove a point. Don't get me wrong. I fully understand your question." And then he asked Rockstar Insider Tez Funds 2, "Any word on new save internals for servers for preventing stuff like this?" And he said, "I think Rockstar considers the possibility of money glitches when making features like this, especially the Bogdan problem glitch. So it won't make sense for them to keep your money until you either win or lose. And then no, there's still no fix for instant disconnection slash quit because it happens in an instance. However, the way around it is to have the game withdraw your money before you play." So that brings up a good point there. With all the glitches in GTA Online, you'd think Rockstar would want to be very careful with something like this. However, I think Tez Funds 2 brings up a really good point at the end, and I think it'll work exactly like it does in Red Dead Online. In order to prevent you from doing that in Red Dead Online, when you buy into a table, you have to give the game your money first. And then the only way you get your money back is if you successfully leave the table. If you quit or you disconnect, you lose all of your money. So I think it's going to work the exact same way in GTA Online. When you do any of the gambling games, you have to put your money up front. At least ones where you sit at a table and it's more of a drawn out process. For things like a slot machine or, you know, the lucky wheel, as they're describing it. I honestly don't know how that's going to work. All I know is that Rockstar has had years to think about how they're going to do this. Remember, the casino was going to be added in 2014 for a single-player update, and it was also going to be added then in GTA Online. Well, we know that that never happened in single-player, and since then, it's been 5 years. So they've had a lot of time to consider this, and that might be one of the reasons why it's taking a bit longer to have this update come out. Rockstar want to make sure, A, they're good to go with all the legal rules and regulations, but also, B, they want to make sure that there's no way for people to easily abuse their new system in online, as that would be very frustrating if you were about to win a hand of poker and then the person you were playing with just pulls the plug on their PlayStation because they didn't want to, you know, lose all that money. So hopefully we will see a system like that. Again, only time will tell, and we'll really have to wait until the update comes out in order to test if that is truly the case. Anyways, let's move on to another topic. I know a lot of you guys are very eager to potentially see when the trailer for the casino update is going to come out. Hopefully, this is one of those updates where we get the trailer before the DLC actually arrives. It's kind of like 50-50 split. Some updates, we get the trailer on the day the update comes out, like with Import-Export and with the Bikers update. Sometimes we get it well before, like with After Hours. So my good friend Alex on Twitter asked, "When do you guys think the Casino DLC trailer will come out?" And Rockstar Insider Tez Funds 2 said, "Early July," with a question mark. And that would make sense. However, that means if that is the case, we might have to put our patient pants on just a little bit longer. Because I know a lot of people, including myself, are anxiously awaiting Thursday when we will hopefully get some new information from Rockstar, but it looks like they might not necessarily give us a trailer on that date. Rockstar have certainly been taking baby steps so far. Remember, two Thursdays ago, all we got was a simple logo and a brief description. Last Thursday, we got a more enhanced logo and about 3 or 4 paragraphs worth of a description. So maybe this time we'll get a couple of screenshots describing what those are, but we might not necessarily get the actual trailer. So again, we're just going to have to put our patient pants on. Now, I find this stat to be kind of interesting. Rockstar Insider Tez Funds 2 put out this tweet the other day. He says, it has been 5 years and 9 months since GTA 5's release, and Grand Theft Auto Online is still receiving updates. It doesn't look like Rockstar is planning to stop. We could see more after the next DLC. This is quite impressive. Not to mention, it is the most profitable entertainment product of all time. So, Rockstar insider Tez Funds 2 believes that this will not be the final update, that whatever this casino update is going to be called will not be the last one. Now, that's kind of interesting because he responded to someone else where he stated the import-export update was supposed to be the final update, and the same applies to the Doomsday heist. So what I think is going on is Rockstar keep releasing these updates to GTA Online, and they suspect that it will be the final one they do. However, I think the updates perform so well for them with A, the amount of players that get on, and B, the amount of money they make from shark card sales, that they say, why the heck not? Let's just keep making the updates. And I'm kind of glad that this is the case because I still feel like there's a lot of unexplored themes that they've done. The casino is certainly one of them, and I'm really excited about that. But hopefully it's not the last update. I really do enjoy the GTA Online updates. I'm sure all of you guys do as well. Now, the only thing I hope is that these online updates don't delay the addition of a new Rockstar game coming out, whether that's Bully 2 or GTA 6. It's kind of a separate topic for another day, but regardless, interesting details. Now, speaking of Thursday, the last three Thursdays, Rockstar have made changes to the Grand Theft Auto Online casino. Outside the front of it, they've removed the opening soon sign. They have added props out front. And if you're like me, you're going to be anxiously waiting for this Thursday to see if Rockstar will be adding new props to the outside of the casino. Now, Rockstar insiders have stated that they believe there are no more changes coming. However, if you are curious as to when those changes do occur, they happen at 5 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, which is different from when the rest of the tunables update. I don't know why Rockstar made them at a separate time. Maybe they did that on purpose. Maybe it was random. Who knows? But changes to the casino, if there are going to be new ones, happen at 5 a.m. EST. And in case you guys are wondering what those changes look like in real time, this is footage from a user on Twitter, -GTA. So thanks to him for providing this. It literally like pops in an instant. It's really cool. I had actually never seen this happen before. And when you see it, it looks really, really strange. But you can see that you get the notification on the screen and then boom, all the changes happen. So big thanks to -GTA for providing this footage, but that is what it looks like when the new casino props sort of load in. They just sort of like flash right in front of your eyes, which is kind of cool. So again, if we're going to be getting new ones, it'll happen like that, and it will happen at 5 a.m. Moving on, something we talked about the other day were those casino characters that were found. Well, someone asked Rockstar insider Tez Funds 2. They said, so is he going to be a character in the update? Do you have any other screenshots or information? And he said, no, it's just a coincidence that this character model, which was used to test out how things would work in the casino, is also played by a popular member of the RP community where he plays as an old man. So I would almost guarantee you, since those models look so old, that Rockstar will be updating the characters and the NPCs we see inside of the casino. But who knows, maybe Rockstar will sort of give us a funny little Easter egg and include that old man in there just because. That'd be kind of cool. And the final thing we're going to be talking about in this video today is the Steam database page for GTA 5. This is where a lot of people go to look to see if any changes are being made to Grand Theft Auto 5. And right now you can see there's a couple of things we need to focus on. The public branch, which was last updated 5 months ago. QA Beta, which stands for Quality Assurance Beta, was updated 4 months ago, and then QA Beta 2 and 3 were both updated 21 hours ago. Now you might be wondering, what does QA Beta 2 and 3 mean? Well, it's typically used for things like this, like a background update where God Mode and Off the Radar glitch was patched, and a couple of duplication glitches patched as well. That's what Rockstar used those QA Beta branches for. So even though you saw it be updated 21 hours ago, doesn't necessarily mean that those are changes specific to the casino update coming up next, but likely things that are being fixed in online right now, probably to prepare for that update. I would imagine getting rid of God mode and off-the-radar glitches is probably a pretty good thing you want to tackle before the next update arrives. But anyways, that's all the information that I've got for you guys in this video today. Hopefully you did enjoy. If you did, be sure to leave a like rating on this video. That would be awesome. And subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new or you like daily GTA 5 videos like this and you want to stay up to date with all the latest casino update news that's going to be going on. So if you'd like to be the first to be notified, hit that notification bell as well. But as always, thank you guys so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you in the next video.